I realized that singing was my passion around the age of 7 because that's when I started doing musical theater. So by starting, yeah, 7, exactly. So once I started to get into musical theater, I realized how much I loved it. And I realized that I just wanted to be on a stage for the rest of my life. And here I am, 23 years old and still kicking. We'll give it a shot. On The Voice for me was just a mixture of people that were supportive and loving of one another. I absolutely loved getting to work with 3 different coaches. So getting to work with Kelly Clarkson, Adam Levine, and then finishing off the season with Miss Alicia Keys. And I think it was just so supportive. Everybody wanted you to do your best. There was never any negative energy. It was just do whatever you can, get on that stage and feel like you're meant to belong there. And I feel like that's what I tried to do with every single performance that I had, was just give it my all, and I loved it every second. Ain't it fun living in the free world? Oh yes, good news. Ain't it good, ain't it good, the end all along. It was a little different for each judge because I spent most of my time with Alicia, so like I really got to know her on a personal level. So like with Alicia, she's just a total Mother Teresa. She is just so warming, so loving. She wants the best out of you, and I really felt like nurtured with her. With Kelly, she's like your favorite aunt, okay? Whoever your favorite family member is, that's Miss Kelly Clarkson. She's so much fun. She's the life of the party. And Adam, I just can tell he's really dedicated about music, and I loved getting to work with him because he has such a clear vision as to what he wants. Eye on the prize. Okay, piping. Since you've been gone, I can't breathe for the first time. I'm so moving on, yeah, yeah. Thanks to you, now I get. Realizing that I think I had a lot of doubts before being on The Voice about, am I gonna make it as an artist? I didn't really know, but the second that I took that Voice stage and all of a sudden I saw fans from not only across the US but across the world, like people reaching out saying there's something about my voice that they love, and I think that just instilled a whole new sense of confidence and me realizing that like I actually can do this and like I have a purpose to do this. And so I think being on The Voice kind of like woke that. This is your kind of song.
No, let it go, let it go, can't hold it back anymore. Let it go, let it go, turn away and slam the door. So I put my hands up, playing my song, the butterflies fly away. Nodding my head like yeah, moving my hips like yeah. Put my hands up, playing my song, you know I'm gonna be okay. Yeah, it's a party in the USA.
But I would say my spirit animal is a golden retriever puppy, though not full grown. We're talking about a little puppy, because people would say like I'm always very spunky and I always have a smile on my face, like I never am in a bad mood. And I feel like every time you look at a golden retriever puppy, nothing against any other type of puppy, but they're just, everyone just looks at them and they're like, oh, they're so cute. And I want to be cute.
Ready? All together now.